The 3-2-1 backup strategy is often touted as the best way to protect yourself from unexpected data loss. The name 3-2-1 refers to the following practice. Make 3 copies of your important data. Store those copies on 2 different media formats. Have one of those copies stored off-site. This video will show how you can use ChronoSync's unrivaled versatility to implement a 3-2-1 strategy. We will begin by creating a bootable backup. This will be your primary backup and your first line of defense against data loss. Next, we will back up our home folder to a NAS device. Because the NAS is in a different room, it provides protection against physical computer damage or theft. Last, we will create a backup to Amazon S3 cloud storage. Because it is off-site, it protects against catastrophic damage, such as fire or flooding. To create a bootable backup, just invoke the bootable backup assistant. After providing administrator credentials, choose the boot volume as the source. An external hard drive attached to our computer will be the destination. The assistant can format the external drive for us, and even encrypt it. But for this example, we'll leave it as is. We'll stick with the default settings for deletion handling and let the assistant choose the task name for us. The bootable backup task is now ready to run. The next backup task will target a NAS device in another room. To get started, invoke the Home Folder Backup Assistant. We make sure our NAS volume is mounted, and then create a folder on it to be the destination. We will exclude folders that have limited backup value, such as downloads and library. Keep the default settings for deletion and archive handling. We'll also use the task name the assistant chose for us. Our home folder to NAS task is now ready to run. The last backup task we'll create will also back up our home folder, but we'll use the cloud as its destination. To start, select the home folder to NAS task that we just created in the ChronoSync organizer. Right-click or option-click and choose Duplicate from the contextual menu. We'll name our new task Backup Home Folder to Cloud. Open the duplicated task. On the destination target, click the Connect to pop-up menu and choose Create Connection. Name the profile S3 Cloud and choose Amazon S3 as the connection type. Supply your access key and secret credentials. After testing your settings, you can save the profile. A connection to Amazon S3 will be established. We'll then create a folder on S3 to contain the home folder backup. ChronoSync suggests some configuration changes because now we're targeting the cloud. We'll let ChronoSync change them for us. We'll also switch to options to enable progressive scanning and change the number of concurrent operations to 8. Our home folder to cloud task is now ready to run. With the 3 backup tasks created, we can run them whenever we'd like, right from the organizer window. However, one of the biggest problems with any backup strategy is failing to run your backups regularly. To eliminate that problem, we'll schedule these tasks to run automatically. Since the bootable backup task is our primary backup, we want it to run frequently. We select it and click Schedule in the Organizer window. Here we specify that we want it to run every day at 12 and 5 p.m. The home folder to NAS task will run less frequently and at times when our network is less busy. Here we've chosen Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 10 p.m. Since the home folder to cloud task is backing up to the cloud, it will run much slower than the other tasks. Because of this, we're scheduling it to run every morning at 1 a.m. We're also instructing it to stop running at 9 a.m. so it doesn't consume all of our internet bandwidth. Because we've enabled progressive scanning, each time it runs, it will pick up where it left off until it has caught up with all the files. This has been just one example of how ChronoSync can implement a 3-2-1 backup strategy. There are countless variations that can be applied to meet your specific needs. For more information, visit the ChronoSync resources page at econtechnologies.com.